All right, so let's start. Good afternoon. It is my great pleasure to share with you this list of best practices on the cloud, which means that how can we develop a mini program on the WeChat in 7 days. My name is Tinafang, and I'm a product manager of the Tencent Cloud. Today, I would like to share our practice with you with my co-workers, Mason. Well, actually, I would like to know that how many of you have already used the mini program of the WeChat Tencent, please? Okay, almost all of you. And how many of you use the serverless mini programs on the WeChat? Well, actually, some of you already attend our workshop yesterday, and quite a lot of you already used that kind of mini program. And today, I would like to share with you a case and then the development progress. And later, I would like to share with you the background of the mini program. And finally, as the product manager, I'd like to give you the elaboration and the product architecture. Mason, who will share with you how to put that into the practice and tackle the challenges during the development. And last, I would like to give you a summary. So let's go back to March last year. So just treat me as a product manager of the album from the Tencent, and then I would like to share with you what does that look. And all the products are motivated from an idea. And this kind of the album was the album in the Kill Zoom. At that time, you can access to these albums via the mobile phones and the PCs. But actually, there is a bottleneck regarding to the increase of the users. In order to have more active users and to attract more users to use this free album, we hope that we can present the Tencent album in the mini program format. So this is how it looks. I don't know whether you can see it clearly or not. Why we choose the mini program? I would like to share with you some data. First, mini program is not mini. In 2019, in the quarter one, the combined users of the WeChat and WeChat has already reached 1.1 billion. And in the beginning of the 2017 to the end of the 2018, it has already have 230 million active users on the WeChat. So we know that there are a lot of the active users on the WeChat. We know that mini program is really convenient in the WeChat. There are some advantages. First one is really fast, and it's really fast to open. You don't need to download that. And the second one, you don't need to compatible it or change it. You can develop it, and then it can be compatible with the Android user, Android device or the iOS users, and you can send it to your friends or to the group chat. And the experience is really good. You can use it as good as the native program, and you can also get it by searching and by the repos of others. The threshold of having this kind of the mini program is really low, and all the people and the enterprise can register an account and then develop this kind of the mini program as the product manager, and I'd like to meet the requirements of the users. And for the development, for the developers, they need to have some ideas, and for this, and in order to develop this album, it must be able to access to the pictures. It must be work as a platform for the social network. For example, it can be liked and thumbed up by others. And we know that former product of this mini program is the album on the Kill Zone, so we believe that they would have a lot of the users. At the very beginning, we hope that we can launch it in 4 weeks. The timeline is really clear, and now I would like to give the floor to the Mason, my co-workers, and he will share with you how he tackled all the challenges he met. Good afternoon, my name is Mason. I am the advanced architecture in the Tencent Cloud. I would like to share with you how can we deliver this mini program in technical. And later, my task is quite technical, so I hope that you can understand me. Tina is really clear that the mini program has some functions, and it has four keywords. more fast, good, and safe. So we need to have the mini program which can have more than 10 million users, which means that it must be stable. So in order to launch it in 4 weeks, it's quite hard and quite difficult if we need to develop in the traditional way. So let's see that's what we need to do if we develop in the traditional way. First, we need to have the enough manpower to support the project development. First, we need to have the front-end engineer, two back-end manager, and one tester, and two maintainers. And if we can have these kind of staff from other projects team, it is really great, and I can develop that within 1 week. But actually, if we cannot do that, we need to recruit more staff, and I don't know that how long we can recruit the capital number. And after we have the team, we need to build the architect. We need to buy the domain name, to buy the machines, and to help me to deploy the environments. For example, I need to use the JS to develop the mini program, and need to ask the manager to install the CPU and to build a lot of the lock system and monitor system. And after that, the front end manager and engineer and the back end engineer can develop the mini program on these environments, and then the tester can involve, and then maintainers can help me to deploy the mini programs on the inline environment, and then I'll just release it to the environment. And if everything goes well, it will take at least 8 weeks. And if I don't have enough team member, it will be longer. So it's really hard to control. I cannot give the final products to Tina within the time available. So what can we do? We think that the main problem is the environment building and the development. So let's look at the development. In the development, besides the business logic, I need to understand the framework. I need to know what kind of framework I would like to use and how to operate the database and the storage. And in addition, I need to pay attention to the performance. Of course, I also have to use some code, and this kind of the code must be robust enough. They must be robust enough to support the usage, and I need to know the environment. For example, the Kubernetes, and for the maintainers, they need to pay attention to the stability and the safety of the mini program. So from top to down, it is quite challenging for the capacity of the team, and we need to invest more time in the code development and in optimization, as well as in the optimization of the performance and the robust of the mini program. So, if the team can nail the development and the environment, I can apply for the deployment on the online. So I will have this kind of the picture. We know that maintenance is quite painful. Besides paying attention to the business clusters, it needs to pay attention to the stability of the modules and the components. And the testing is quite challenging as well. Besides the testing of the function and the features, I need to test the performance of all the modules and the components, and I need to know that whether it's still stable when millions of the users are using these mini programs at the same time. So it is not so hard for the developers. They don't need to care about so many details, but for the developers, they need to develop a really good architect to support the iteration of the functions later. So I need to have a question for the program. How about the safety and how about the stability for our team? We are not really good at operating and maintaining the environment. So if we can reduce the components which has nothing to do with the core business, for example, the poor balancing and the safety, if all these things can be done by the operators and maintainers of the Tencent of the WeChat, it would be really simple. I just pay attention to the business logic, and this will be the architect I need to pay attention to, the back cluster and the database as well as the storage. And this kind of the architecture looks really perfect because everything has nothing to do with the core business, such as the architecture and maintenance has already been shielded. So whether it can be realized or not, well, the answer is definite. Because we have the serverless concept, so we can really convenient to remove the maintenance and the resources which has nothing to do with the core business. So for the users, so they just use the serverless solutions to build the architect. The serverless concept has already been available for a really long time in the beginning of the last year, and the WeChat and Tencent Cloud just combined together to develop on the serverless, which is benefit from the FUS in China because of the availability of the FUS, the computing of the core business can be serverless.
So after serverless is available, then what convenience will it deliver to the
development?
You can see the structure here. So behind the cloud development is the background or mini program development. It has this cloud function, storage, database.
After
this resource envelope, they can become available to users in the form of VPN and users can use it right away.
And the mini program
sent the request which will be delivered to the cloud development in a special line. So the security is guaranteed. And the background is based on serverless. So there is no issues about high co-occurrence or other issues because this service will be delivered by and this enables the maintenance team for real-time monitoring.
This
helps the maintenance team to ease their job.
These are the features.
It looks abstract. We can take a close look about the application of, for example, cloud development. Suppose that I've already had a mini program,
a demo,
and I want to deploy it based on this cloud development. Then how should I do it? First, I need to build a new project, and I can import the existing project. Suppose that I've already have WeChat ID, and this is the official ID. And with this ID, then I can develop the mini program easily. This is a simulation of this interface of mini program, and on the right is the simulation of the development, for example, deployment of functions. I can easily upload the functions to the cloud. On the right, you can see the development is achieved.
And
this is the interface of the mini program. And we go to the background, and we can see the
functions.
I can save these review for my album, and then we can see the cloud function is deployed successfully. On the right,
on the left,
you can see the environment ID. And I need to pick this environment I'm going to use. And if you have developed the mini program, you feel about the authentication can be complicated. But here, it has this inbuilt user authentication, then you can get the user's open ID easily. Let's go to the background.
Let's say
database, and the user login successfully for storage, because there's no picture upload, so you don't see any info here. And he log in successfully, then we can get the user's
open
ID.
I
can compile or preview it easily on the mobile phone. For example, I want to preview a QR
okay,
code.
然后我可以在, 接下来我就在那个手机端去扫码去,
I can use the cell phone to scan the QR code for to test the, this mini program.
这个是我的用户登录,
this is my user's login, and this is the album. I can create the demo name for this album, for example, demo.
In this album,
I can submit a picture.
OK, 已经功能是都是都是OK了。然后其实这样的一套系统的话，我已经是我已经参考好了。从我导入完成，这是我已经参考好了。从我导入完成，这是我已经参考好了。从我导入完成，这是我已经参考好了。从我导入完成，这是我已经参考好了。从我导入完成，这是我已经参考好了。从我导入完成，这是我已经参考好了。从我导入完成，这是我已经参考好了。从我导入完成，这是我已经参考好了。从我导入完成，这是我已经参考好了。从我导入完成，这是我已经参考好了。从我导入完成，这是我已经参考好了。从我导入完成，这是我已经参考好了。从我导入完成，这是我已经参考好了。从我导入完成，这是我已经参考好了。从我导入完成，这是我已经参考好了。从我导入完成，这是我已经参考好了。从我导入完成，这是我已经参考好了。从我导入完成，这是我已经参考好了。从我导入完成，这是我已经参考好了。从我导入完成，这是我已经参考好了。从我导入完
to accommodate millions of users, then I need to know what is fast, what is serverless, what is fast. And for developers, it's easy. They just need to upload the module and the code. That would be fast. And when I have this mini program end, when there is a request, I can just send the request to the platform, and the fast will pull enough instances to meet my request. And in the cloud function instance, I can call the storage AI interface. This is so-called fast and bus. And in this structure, is so the combination of fast and bus. This is actually a presentation of serverless. So in the structure, serverless use the underlying resources as an API and envelope and provide it to users. So what are the features of serverless?
First,
it provides infinite elastic computing power at the back end. Second, user can get the business code easily because it's out of box. So they don't need to be worried about server or back end environment. Thirdly, when there is a request from the mini program end, then they can call the SDK easily and run the function. It's automatic. And at the back end, the functions after written, it can be deployed easily at the background. Then basically is zero maintenance. So I've talked about the structure. Now let's look at the implementation of a serverless. The core function of Tencent Elven is social feature. If I use the traditional development approach, there will be a lot of challenges. First, I need to have enough maintenance power to build and monitor the logging system. Second, developers need to choose the framework to write the logic, to build the code, and there is historical burdens as well. It's very difficult for me to add new features based on the existing background or structure. But with serverless, these challenges are no longer a problem to us. When I send the request and this request will be delivered to the cloud function, and the cloud function will work on the authentication. After it is authenticated, this request will go back to the cloud function. The cloud function then operates the database.
Okay. 然后我再以实际的代码，然后再举个例子，就是说对于传统模式，我需要实现一个这样的社交功能，我的后端，我需要关注方向的网络，还有包括用户的OK的获取。
用户要关注，还有 attention to routing and the safety and maintenance. But with serverless, with SDK, then I can call right away the cloud function at the back end. I can pick WeChat, the cloud, and cloud function. Then I can require to go back to the back end and to realize this mini program. And in this cloud function, after I get the request, in the context, I can get user's open ID easily, so I don't need to ask for authentication to WeChat. This is a code example. What about its performance?
For example,
at the end of last month,
I
can see the request and the total time consumption is below 7 milliseconds. In other words, the cloud function can respond to your request stably.
So,
for a brief summary, this is a comparison of traditional approach and serverless approach. So we can see in terms of manpower, the traditional approach would require 10 weeks dedicated engagement of one person, and the maintenance team, it will also require maintenance team to do the online maintenance. But for serverless approach, one person can spend only 3 weeks and he can work on the front end and back end work.
And
the test can be completed in a week by a person. So we can see that serverless approach helps us to minimize or streamline the structure for a mini program.
Let's say
it's like it has two separated backgrounds. The maintenance team no longer need to monitor the login system or other system.
And
it takes a lot of less time for development. That's why with a serverless approach, then I can develop a beta version mini program in 2 weeks. This mini program reached
got
10 million users by the end of last year, which is ahead of our set target. So now I would like to give the floor to Tina again. So Tina will talk about what would happen when Tencent Serverless meets WeChat Mini Program. Thank you, Mason, for your detailed presentation. So after we launched this mini program, maybe we can talk about what would happen when the serverless Tencent serverless meets the WeChat mini program. First, it encourages higher development efficiency. And for enterprises and individuals, basically, it entrusts the features to the cloud. Then individuals and the enterprise, they can focus on their own core business logic. And it is high available and it supports auto scaling. And it helps to reduce resource investment, including the manpower input and the financial input. Because it supports the use by demand. And the WeChat mini program development, you leverage the serverless as a platform, and we can realize the app or program development easily, and we don't need to pay attention about the details. So you may wonder about the customers. Actually, there are many customers who use this serverless structure. They are from education sector, e-commerce, and also internet company as well. They are now transforming to serverless structure. So I hope that when we want to implement our idea, it can be a mini program or mini game. I hope everyone can realize their idea or realize their dream. So we really want to set the bar low. And with this platform, it will help you to implement your idea.
Okay,
and then I already share all the things I would like to share with you today. If you are interested in the topic and your questions are welcome. And we would like to extend our team as well. So if you are interested to join us, welcome to talk to us. This is the public account of the cloud native of the Tencent. The resource available later will be also be available in this WeChat account as well.
The serverless
is quite mature regarding to the development of the mini program. And we also have a lot of the cases as well. Currently, there are a lot of internet companies that are restructuring. So if you are really interested, and you can scan the QR code, and you can also scan the QR code to join the QQ chatting group to talk to us as well. So any questions from the floor?
Good afternoon. I would like to know that
is the serverless is the open source or not? So compared to other emerging serverless framework, any other advantage and disadvantage of the serverless? Or any other scenarios are not suitable to use the serverless? Well, I think this is a really great question. Well, I'd like to elaborate the serverless a little bit. Well, actually, serverless is born earlier than the Kinetic. So the relationship between these two is that the framework of the Kinetic and the serverless framework is different. Well, for the serverless, we just build everything on the Kubernetes, and we also use the Kubernetes for the scheduling. And we also use the virtual machine later. So we don't think that container is as safe as the virtual machine. But all these kinds of problems of the Kinetic is also challenges for the serverless as well. For example, the cold store is that, so our value is that to optimize the serverless. The most important is the ecosystem for the serverless. A lot of people think that it is a little bit closed, but will help the developers to launch a lot of IDE, the DevOps. All this will reduce the threshold of the developers or the development. And for the Kinetic, I think that in order to improve that, they need to improve their ecosystem as well. Well, actually, it's also the same for the serverless. No matter how great it is, no one can use it. It is that it's meaningless. And after the launching of the mini program, it has more than 10 million of the users because that it also attracts the users of the WeChat. Well, I would like to add something as well. A lot of people think that what we do is the same as the event trigger. The message is mentioned that it will have problems such as the cold start. And all these kind of event trigger thing is not suitable for the program, which will have a lot of the concurrence. But actually, we also have the 2.0 network. Besides this, we also want to use the service method to support the service framework, which means that from the front end to the end, back end, I may already use the development architecture of the framework or the microservice framework. We hope that we can transfer that to the serverless platform, and we are also working on this part as well.
I
think your demo is really great because you have a lot of the users. So my understanding is that if you have a lot of the users, we will create a lot of the containers and also have the database in the background. So I'd like to know that the execution environment is connected to the database directly or not, and how to deal with the container problem.
Well, the second question is that
for the development kit, for the mini program, you also have the WS and cloud. So I would like to know that you have already integrated to the NDDK and the kit or not. Well, actually, your questions are really great as well. I would like to answer the first one. For a lot of users, when they develop the program, when they write down the business code, they always have the connection tool, and this problem must be solved in the service as well. But when you build a connect pool, when I have a lot of users in the background, it's already a resource pool. And I just mentioned that the containers in the background, there is already a very big resource pool for the cluster, so the users, they don't need to create the container as well. They just send the request, it's okay, so it can reduce the process of the development. And when I connect to the database, there is a connecting pool or the resource pool connected to the database. What I need to do is to schedule the socket. When the request is a pool, I just can ask the database. So on both ends, there is a pool so that the users doesn't need to worry that whether they need to connect to the resource pool or not. They just reschedule the socket, it's okay. And another one is the help function of the WeChat. Actually, the backstage program has already been packaging. So when the SDK is imported to the WeChat, they can use the WeChat upload or the WeChat data or the WeChat function. So in this way, they can schedule the sockets in the backstage, and in this way, they can skip all the steps in the middle. And I think that SDK will be the trend as well. So later, besides the computing, it can be serverless with that in the database storage. I don't need to worry about the resource pool. I don't want to hear about that. I hope that the database can help us to do all the things via the database. They can help me to deal with the failure tolerance. What is the cost of using
this
Yeah, I think it's okay to use the free package. And later, if the mini program it is really great, and I will have a lot of users, and I will have a lot of the package, you can upgrade the package. So the upgraded one can accommodate millions,
10 millions of the requests a day.
Well, actually, we also give you some discounts as well for the specific price, and I'll tell you later. And actually, I'll just give you a comparison between the serverless one and the serverless one. When you use the serverless, you don't need to pay so much attention to the operation and the maintenance. And the package is also charged based on the requirement, which means that if you don't have any request sent during the night time, you don't need to cost anything. So as long as your CPU usage is lower than 70%, I think that the free package is really a good deal for you. Well, actually, due to the time limitation, if you have any questions, you are welcome to talk to us privately.